Hi, this is Rich. Welcome to my blog. Hey, I've been looking at some information here on the internet and I'm trying to put it together and I'm trying to figure out how to present it to you. So after about 10 outtakes, I'm going to try this. I have some tabs open on my browser and I'm just going to click them real fast and go over them real quickly and then come back and share the narrative. Hopefully that's how it goes if I don't go sideways on this, okay? Okay, so to be clear, a conspiracy is a secret plan by a group to do something unlawful or harmful. Okay? Just enough said for now. The deep state is a body of people, typically influential members of government agencies or the military, believed to be involved in secret manipulation or control of government policy. Okay? Speculate. Because I am going to speculate. Form a theory or conjecture about a subject without firm evidence. Okay? So let's look at the evidence that's not quite firm briefly. Let's go through the talking points here. Mysterious objects spotted over Washington State. Military denies missile launch. Well, what else do we have here? The object was spotted at 3:56 a.m. over Whidbey Island near a naval air station. Naval air people deny rockets. They don't have missiles there. Okay, fair enough. No missiles on that plane. All right, fine. Next. A secret missile launch, mystery streak of light spotted over Whidbey Island leaves locals baffled. Well, let's look. We got this photo. This is the one we saw. That's a photograph of it. Okay, well, they're denying that it is a missile strike, but let's look what a missile looks like going up. Here's a missile. Just Google it. U.S. Air Force tests missile. And here's another one. Missile. Missile? Question mark. We would probably say, yeah, definitely missile, if we had some agreement on that. Okay? But what is it? Next talking point here. Was a nuclear attack on Hawaii thwarted by the secret space program? What? Yeah, on Saturday morning, January 13th, residents of Hawaiian Island received an emergency alert that warned of an incoming ballistic missile. And this is what it looked like on a cell phone. Emergency alert, ballistic missile threat. Inbound to Hawaii, seek immediate shelter. This is not a drill. So this is a real deal. Later they come back and say, "Oops, accident. Sorry, it wasn't real. Didn't really happen." But days after Hawaii false missile alarm, a new one in Japan. What? The erroneous warning sent by the Japanese public broadcaster NHK on Tuesday about a North Korean missile launch. Okay, erroneous. And here's a little more about it. Japan broadcaster sends false Korea missile alert. CNN reports. You can always count on CNN. All right, next. Next talking point here. What else do I have here? Oh, one more. This may or may not apply or be part of this, but serious incident unfolds at NATO as a NATO jet accidentally launches a secret missile near Russian border. What's the date on this? August 11th, 2018. Okay. So, What's going on here? Is the deep state trying to start a war? Let's just shoot a bunch of missiles at shit and see what happens. Deep state, secret, working in secret, planning to do something harmful. That would be, I'm just speculating here. This is my theory, but I'm speculating upon a conspiracy. It would have to be planned and have to be secret. Okay, what else do I have here? Let's look a little further into this. This is at exopolitics.org. The secret Navy behind the ballistic missile attack on Hawaii. I'm like, really? There's such a thing? And this was posted January 20th, 2018. As information continues to emerge confirming that there was a ballistic missile attack against Hawaii that was intercepted on January 13th, the investigation begins to shift from what happened to who is responsible. So this article goes on, different people are speculating on who's responsible. And if they come up with a theory, it's going to be a conspiracy theory. But that's what you have to do when you address conspiracies. And conspiracies are just a bunch of people in secret planning to do their shit that's harmful or illegal. That's all it is. So to be bashing conspiracy theories is nothing more than a strategy, a propaganda strategy to keep people from even thinking who's doing what to who and why that is illegal. All right. So this goes on to say anything. What else? So this is about all of this. And I'll let you look at this yourself. But there's a little something. Here's a little bit about the submarines used. Secret weapon. Secret weapons. It's a pretty good article. Pretty compelling and convincing, actually. We got documents. We got all kinds of stuff. The story, part of the story that is here on this webpage is that, yeah, there are aspects of our government that have their submarines and other things. Okay? It can be guaranteed that the CIA's Directorate of Operations would have similarly justified the acquisition of ballistic missile-capable submarines for its own covert operations around the world. And the CIA is pretty well known for its black budget stuff, and a lot of us are familiar with, there's evidence and documentation that the CIA was involved in drug trafficking, human trafficking, and other things. That's kind of another story, but it ties in with this. Right now, I'm like focused in on this submarine sort of thing. Okay? Okay, the next thing I want to share is something very interesting, and I'll show you how it ties in a minute. Richard Russell stole a plane in Seattle and crashed it. How'd he learn to fly? Let's see, what else does this say? Any significance? The site is in Keytron Island near Seattle, where Richard B. Russell, this is important, Richard B. Russell, a ground service agent employed by blah, 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 stole a Q400 turbojet aircraft. Let's see, are these easy to fly? Mr. Beck says, commercial aircrafts are complex machines, Mr. Beck said at a news conference on Saturday. I don't know how he achieved the experience he did. Me neither. I can only speculate. Okay, let's take a look at his flying expertise, having never flown a plane before. Let's see here. This is the actual footage. of this guy stealing this plane.
What the hell is this guy doing?
Q400. Pretty amazing. Oh, what's this? Look, this little speck here coming this way. I mean, this is within seconds. I mean, this is just 5 minutes. I don't know, but we have a fighter jet scrambled, and it's going after the guy. This is good. Apparently, this fighter jet was launched from in Oregon, the state of Oregon. Anyway, so there's that. Okay? All right. Next. Here's where it gets really interesting and weird. Oh, well, first of all, let's talk about the plane a little bit. It's a Bombardier Q400 aircraft operated by Jazz under... I just picked one of these jets. A lot of companies buy these and use them. And there it is, a Q400. It's got a Q on the tail. Now, I don't know if this actual jet that Richard B. ripped off had these same markings on it, but it was definitely a Q400 turbojet. Okay? All right. Now it starts to get fun. Very curious here. Check this out. What does all this have to do with missiles and real or fake missile attacks or accidents? Check it out. Do we have one more? Just to confirm, this is Richard B. Russell. Okay. There's a lot of strange things that are incongruent with the whole narrative about him stealing the plane. Why? And his tone of voice, what he was saying, what he was talking about it. It's just strange. So we're not going to go into that too much. That's not the point. But Oregon F-15s scrambled to this Seattle to intercept the possibly stolen Q400. Okay? So, key point in my little narrative that I'm going to share in a minute. Okay, here's where it gets really, really interesting. In Bremerton, Washington, there is a submarine, a nuclear sub called the Richard B. Russell. The USS Richard B. Russell, a Sturgeon-class attack submarine. Okay. I won't read the whole article, but you can go there and check it out. Decommissioned in June of 94. Motto, they saved the best for last. And down here, it's a Sturgeon-class attack sub. And is it nuclear? Yes, it is. That's nuclear-powered propulsion. Do they have nukes on it? I don't know. I would imagine. Of course they do. Okay, and here it tells us the decommissioning and disposal. So it says here that the Richard B. Russell was decommissioned and stricken from the Navy Vessel Register. In other words, yeah, okay. But she was stored at Bremerton, Washington until October 1st, 2001. This is a 1 month after the 9/11 attack. World Trade Center. Okay, at this time, she entered into the nuclear-powered ship and submarine recycling program. At Bremerton. Oh, at Puget Sound Naval Shipyard in Bremerton for scrapping. Okay. All right. I'm about to speculate here. Be careful. But first, where are these places? Where is this place? Okay. Here's Whidbey Island. And this is where that missile launch looking thing happened. Was it a missile launch or was it not? Here's Seattle. Here's Key Tron Island, where the Richard B. Russell pilot or guy stole the plane and crashed. That we're told that he crashed there. And then we saw crash site debris from afar on day one. So, anyway, next, where's Bremerton? Oh, here's Bremerton, here's Key Tron, and here's Whitby. So, a decommissioned, dismantled nuclear sub was dismantled and decommissioned somewhere around here. Okay? Now, for my little narrative, you ready? Oh man. What if there really is a shadow war, secret war against the deep state, Donald Trump and the current white hats in our government and military really are trying to stop World War III from happening while the deep state, the organized crime syndicate, cabal, New World Order gang, or if they're starting to, they're trying to start World War III. Just launch some fucking missiles at shit and see it and blame it on somebody else. Do it in secret so those who get attacked won't know who hit them. But those attacks are being thwarted. Those attacks are failing. What if this QAnon intelligence, the military intelligence that most people that follow the Q stuff, most of us understand or agree that the Q posts are being dropped by military intelligence working with Trump in support of Trump and the support of making America great again and in support of the Constitution. So Donald Trump has made it clear that he's at war with the deep state. He wants to take the deep state out, and he wants to take care of the human trafficking problem, big problem. So the human trafficking and child trafficking has a lot to do with the super rich and the power elite and their pedophilia stuff, the Pizzagate thing, and just so many different things. The Clinton Foundation, all of this. So the current administration and the white hats in Congress are working the problem. And what is necessary for the white hats to win is that in this coming election, the Republican Party get the Republican Party people in support of Trump get elected and get positioned within Congress. And this will give us a strong Congress in support of the president, which is in support of cleaning up the swamp, the deep state. Okay? The deep state have control of mainstream media, the super rich power elite that are not, they may be U.S. citizens, but they are not patriots and they're not for America or the Constitution. They are for their own cabal, their own elite group, and their own agenda. Okay? So, they have control of the media. I mean, they literally buy it. what's his name? Bezos, this guy right here, he lives in Washington. Here's Whidbey Island. This is Bezos here, and he lives in Washington. He bought the Washington Post. So, yeah, this is a little side point here, but the super rich power elite own the media, okay? Turner Broadcasting. Turner was the original builder or creator of CNN. I think he might have sold it off to another bunch, but anyway. Back to my narrative here. So, what if the Democrats, the deep state, with their mainstream media propaganda doing everything they can to bash the Republican Party and Trump and call this the QAnon phenomena a conspiracy theory. It's, among other things, what it is information being dropped on these what they call Q boards, and they basically give us clues to what's going on, what has gone on, what is going on now, and what's going to happen in the future. And whoever Q is drops links, look at this, look into these people, follow the wives of these bad actors, and they just, the information on the Q boards keep giving those of us who are interested clues and direction, what to research and what to look into. And it leaves it to us to connect the dots and draw our own conclusions. Think for ourselves, think logically. There's nothing conspiratorial about it. But it does point out that bad people in powerful places conspire together. They plan in secret to do unlawful and illegal things. So this exposes a conspiracy of mass proportions, this QAnon information. And so, of course, the conspirators, whether you want to look at it as New World Order, the power elite, super rich, the 13 families, the cabal, the Khazarian mafia, the deep state, the Freemasons, the Masonics, whatever you want to call this organized crime of mass proportions. If you theorize or speculate who they are, what they're doing, and why, you are, by definition, a conspiracy theorist. You're coming up with a theory. But there's nothing wrong with that. We have to theorize on what's wrong in a situation in order to come up with a theory of what the problem is and another theory on what might fix it. So anyway, what if the deep state with their Democratic Party and their mainstream media bashing and all their dirty tricks and all these things they've been doing, what if they realized they're not going to win they're not going to win the election in the primaries? It's not going to happen. They can't turn it around. They got this barbarous, this got the Streisand effect, which is the effect of trying to suppress something, the activity of trying to suppress the thing blows it up out of proportion and makes it more known than ever. And that's what they tried to do with the Q phenomenon. it's like with all these over-the-top mainstream media bashing of the QAnon, more and more people have looked into it. It's not a bad thing. It's a really good thing. I've been following it for about 4 months now. So anyway, what if Deep State and the Democratic Party, the Hillary gang, and all that, those corrupt people in the Department of Justice and the FBI that have been working together, conspiring to commit unlawful acts and do harmful things. What if they realized they're not going to win the election, meaning they're not going to have their people in Congress to continue stopping or tying the president up in bullshit and stonewalling and false flags? And what if they realize they cannot stop this, and after the election there's going to be too many people in support of Trump, in support of the Constitution, too many people in there that know and understand what the deep state is and is on board with taking down the deep state, cleaning the swamp? So what if the deep state knows this and knows that if this happens, the support of Trump happens within Congress, whether they're Democrats or Republicans, they get the support they need to get the legislation and get the government moving in the right direction of cleaning out the swamp all throughout America and globally. What if the deep state has realized there's no stopping it? So they have to move to, this is my speculation, they have to move to plan B. Bad guys have to move to plan B. Plan B is start World War freaking III. Get the president so involved in dealing with the war and getting bashed for causing war and all this stuff, getting us involved more, get so caught up in that they can derail his focus on cleaning up things and doing a good job and making America great again. What if that's their plan? And how would they do that? Well, they could try shooting up a rocket that just coincidentally went up the same day, around the same time that Air Force One, President Trump was flying in Air Force One, I think back from the Korean summit. What a coincidence, huh? Do you believe in coincidences? Further investigation, you know, this is a theory, and you want to investigate, is my theory and my speculation accurate or not? So it takes a lot of research. I researched this for 2 days before I was able to, you know, share this, what I'm sharing with you now. And so what if the deep state is doing this? And they're getting blocked, they're getting stopped. What if they actually, this, where is it, right here? What if this submarine, and this is just speculation, come on. This submarine, the Richard B. Russell, never actually got dismantled. Strucken off the records, it basically disappears. But what if the bad guys, the CIA, with, you know, here, they walk in, hi, we're the CIA, we're secret ops, we got this, you know, we've got all this, and we're going to take your fucking submarine. Thank you very much for the submarine. Finish the paperwork, but we want the sub. Yep. And we'll make it look like it was declassified and dismantled when it wasn't. How's that for you? Would that work for you? So anyway, what if that happened? And now, give me a second. So now the deep state has their hands on at least one, probably more, but a sub. And it's named the Richard B. Russell. So what if, and it's total speculation, right? It's like, what else can you do but go, what the hell? Why are these coincidences? A guy named Richard B. Russell in a plane that would, you know, if you're looking for secret code and secret conspiracy shit, this is perfect. What if the good guys, the military intelligence, trying to keep this, they don't want the public, American people, to know how serious this is and what the deep state is doing, because almost half of the American people aren't getting it. They're not getting that it's this serious. And if you just go turn on the Democratic Party and start pointing fingers at them and accusing them of these things, there's so much news media propaganda that would go after the white hats in government, in the White House, in Congress, in the military, that it could cause a tear in the fabric of the United States. See, so everybody wants to keep it, you know, the guys that are they're fighting back and forth, they want to keep it on the down low, okay? And just let it come out slowly so people can absorb it one little bit at a time. Total speculation. What if Q, military intelligence, was intercepting the comms of the bad guys and knew of their next attack? Knew when their next missile launch from their submarine, the Richard B. Russell, was going to happen. What if they knew that? What if that's what it was and they knew it? And they needed to scramble some jets, get them in the air in case the bad guys shot those missiles at who knows what. Well, we got the F-15s in the air, scrambled, right now, we're ready to rock and roll. The deep state sees this, the little submarine goes, uh-oh, better not shoot these missiles today, dead meat. It won't work. So the bad guys in their little Richard B. Russell submarine stand down. At the same time, what if the military intelligence, Q, is giving us tips that we're on top of it? We know what they're doing, we know how they're doing it, and those deep state people are stupid. And what if the military white hats, totally in support of Trump and the white hats in Congress, what if they are telling us, letting us know, people that do know what's going on, telling us, hey, we've got this. So they come up with a Richard B. Russell. How the hell did they do that? Did they fake names? Do they have agents pretending to be Richard B. Russell's relatives? Did they just find a Richard? How the hell did they do that? If they did it, and it's just speculation, and you can say this, no, they're not that smart, you know. Yeah, spy guys aren't that clever and smart, and they can't cover their tracks and build these stories and narratives and cover stories and all that stuff. Well, I don't know. I think they're pretty damn smart. Okay, smarter than me. So what if they were somehow able to get not just a Richard Russell, but a Richard B. Russell that tells us this is a submarine they're using? And not only that, they have them grab a Q plane that tells us Q is on top of this. What? Really? How could that possibly be? I haven't watched all the details of the developments and the latest news on the Richard B. Russell airplane crashing, but as I understand it, it goes off into the distance and crashes on Keytron Island. But did it really? Or did they do a fake crash site? Did that thing land or mysteriously disappear and kind of blend into the background and later come flying in and landing as one more plane that is associated with the company that he stole the plane from. And so just like, oh, no, one more Q plane landing, turbojet, no, not knowing that it's the same one. I'm not saying that happened. I don't think that happened. I don't know what happened. Maybe they did crash it. Did he bail out? We don't know. Okay, so we got all of that. I go, wow, you know, that's really stretching it, man. But how would that guy be able to fly that plane like that, that well? And some people say this loop-de-loop or barrel roll thing he did was kind of like a cue somehow, which be, if so, would be just one more little clue or tidbit for those of us who follow the Q phenomena as an intelligence drop, totally wrapped in code and puzzles and riddles and stuff. So it keeps us engaged. We'll try to figure out what he's saying. And it also keeps us kind of ahead of the game, or at least knowing what's going on, when, why, and how, and all that stuff. So what if the white hats got really pissed at the Skull and Bones attempt? Well, let me put it this way. When President Trump was in Scotland, one of his secret agents on duty right there on the golf course ended up dying of a stroke right after this hand glider flies over. It's ultralight. It's a Greenpeace. Well, I did the research. Greenpeace is in part funded by the Rockefeller brothers. So we could say, you know, it wouldn't take much to speculate that the deep state was sending a message to Trump, taking out his Remington, and his agent Remington. These dark forces, these evil satanic people, they're really into their symbols and their codes and their numbers and their rituals and the geometry and numerology. They're really into all that stuff, big time. So they take out an agent named Remington, which in World War II was a key bridge that shortened the war. It's known to have shortened the war in World War II. So if you're talking in symbols and code and clues, if President Trump is going over to see Putin to shorten the war with the deep state, to work together with Putin to take out the deep state, super rich power elite, Rothschilds, Soros, all of that. Get the symbolism here. Trump going over here to see Putin to shorten the war. Remington just happens to be one of his agents, dies in the line of duty. And we can only speculate because we're not getting the details. What happened? What, you know, who doesn't know? Raise your hand. Who doesn't know about CIA heart attack weapons? Bzz, looks like a heart attack, that sort of thing. So what if Agent Remington took the hit and he was taken out? And so the bridge to shorten the war between the deep state, the white hats and dark hats, the bridge was taken out. An attempt to take the bridge out. Didn't happen. Anyway, moving right along. What if Trump and the white hats, this seriously, okay, game on. So very soon after that, they send the Department of Justice jet to Arkansas, Clinton's backyard, and gathers up all these boxes and documents. We can only, again, we don't get a lot of details, but now I've heard that another big-ass jet flew down a second time. I heard that Sessions was actually in Arkansas the same time that jet was on the first one. And we know that there's major lawsuits in progress right now against the Clinton Foundation, and some of the named defendants are Bill and Hillary Clinton, Soros, and others. This Clinton Foundation, I haven't had time to look into the details, but it seems like they funnel the money. It's like people giving money to the Clinton Foundation, not the Clintons, the foundation. And are they paying for services? Is this where you can buy and sell human trafficking, child trafficking stuff, and other things? Whatever. There's a major lawsuit ongoing right now against the Clinton Foundation. What if the Department of Justice went down to ensure that those documents that literally are in warehouses, they're document storage facilities. What if the Department of Justice went down there and basically went with a subpoena and raided the place, kind of caught them by surprise so they couldn't destroy their documents, or accidentally the warehouse fucking burns up or some damn thing. They get down there with their agents. Boom, here's a subpoena, give us your documents. What if, speculate, right? What if that's what happened? So that the DOJ, the good guys, now that a lot of the DOJ is being cleaned up, so many bad actors have resigned or gotten fired from the Department of Justice. And this whole thing with the Clinton Foundation lawsuit is not part of the Mueller investigation. So this is not, just has nothing to do with classified documents, secret documents. It's a completely different thing. Okay? So the Department of Justice, it's not no obstruction of justice thing going on here. It's a lawsuit, legit. So the Department of Justice steps in, the white hats. They fly in, they land their plane, they catch this is speculation. I don't know what those boxes were, what's in them, or where they got them. But I'm just speculating here, okay? So what if, I'm just repeating myself now, aren't I? What if I'm forming a theory about a subject without firm evidence? What if I'm doing that? And what if my theory is that the Department of Justice went down to grab a lot of documents, tons of documents from the Clinton Foundation? Surprise that, a surprise. Hi, we're here. Here's a subpoena. We've got our agents here. Step out of the way. And they're going, oh, fuck. We are so fucked. And what if that's what happened? And in retaliation of their shot at the president, and their shots with these freaking missile attacks that aren't missile attacks. What if these are missile attacks? Look, that's what missile attacks look like. Why does this not look like a missile? Why is this one not looking like a missile? And why couldn't why couldn't that not a missile come from a Richard B. Russell submarine that didn't get dismantled like it was supposed to? Because why not? We have a secret Navy. It's confirmed, pretty much. There's a lot of people talking about it. And so in determining the type of missile attack against Hawaii, yet another service source refers to a Hawaii tourist boat, blah, blah, blah. A lot of speculation here. Read up. But when it gets down to it, it's a valid theory. But with any theory, you have to start digging around for evidence and get enough evidence, one, for yourself, to convince yourself that whatever the conspiracy is or the thing is, you're convinced. But then the next step is to show others your evidence, your clues, your tips. Like any good investigation, you got to step in and start looking for clues and putting together a narrative and a story. And if you can do this, and you've got enough compelling evidence, then theoretically you should be able to show that to the proper court, to the proper prosecutors who would prosecute. There should be a grand jury and a prosecution. Well, this whole thing is blah, 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 blah. So yeah, anyway. Okay, one last little speculation, okay? This is about all these millionaires, billionaires in Washington. Now, I didn't come up with this, but somebody else is speculating that somebody else wrote a thing, and they said that they were there at Keetron Island after the plane crashed. They lived not too far away. They go over, and what the guy sees is a lot of CIA and a lot of sheriffs from various precincts. Now, how would he know what he's looking at is CIA? I don't know. Maybe, I don't know. But anyway, and how would he know that these are sheriffs from many different precincts? But he's saying there's a whole lot of people there at Keetron Island. For just a plane crash? For a regular, simple plane crash? So his speculation is that what if Keetron Island was another Epstein Island kind of place? What if that? I'm going, whoa, that's just too many things coming converging in one place. I'm going, whoa, 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 whoa. Can we do that later? But then he says, well, you know, there's a lot of billionaires right there in Seattle or in Washington. How close are they to the Keetron Island? If in fact that was another Epstein Island kind of place where all this child trafficking and pay-to-play stuff is going on. I go, oh, really? Well, let me look and see how many billionaires are there. Okay, so I did a quick look here. Billionaires in Washington. So this is the ones we get here. We get Bezos, I guess. This is supposed to jump around. Okay, this is Paul Allen, 21 billion. He lives here. Here's Seattle, not far. And this is Steve Ballmer, 38 billion. Never heard of the guy. He's over here near Seattle. And then we've got this guy, Bill Gates, 90 billion. He's right here. And Jeff is right here. Where's Jeff? Jeff, where you go, Jeff? This is Howard, 2 billion. Jeff, Steve, Charles. I go, well, yeah, there's a lot of billionaires there, all right. And right there near Seattle, and I go back to, well, where's Keetron Island again? Here's Seattle, Keetron. I think it's 40 miles. And Bremerton, the boat place, Seattle, secret submarine hangar, where somewhere. It's just a speculation. I don't know. How the hell would I know? I don't know. But wow, just so much stuff is coming down right now that it just seems like a good idea to me to be paying attention on so many different levels. So I just want to share my speculation and my theories with you. I am not making any bones about it. This is speculation. And let me say one more thing about conspiracies. A secret plan by a group to do something unlawful or unlawful. I've mentioned this before, but I've done so many outtakes, I can't remember anymore. I've done over 10 outtakes on this one presentation already. Conspiracies, the very word conspiracy has been made to sound like it's associated with the crazies and the deranged. But in fact, there are many conspiracies going on all the time. And when you catch wind of one, if you get some clues that there is some kind of, hey, there's a conspiracy, hey, there's a secret plan by a group to do something unlawful or harmful. If you don't know exactly what that plan is, and you have to start putting together the clues and the evidence, and you're onto something, but you don't know if these people are related to these people, Hillary Foundation tied into human trafficking? I don't know, it's just a theory until we get more evidence. So you have to have that theory. So you're always going to be coming up with conspiracy theories. But the turn of phrase has gotten bashed so much by mainstream media that the population, most people in the population, are programmed to think of people who are exposing the truth and coming up with theories on who's doing it, why, and how. And it usually turns back to the deep state, shadow government, somebody in this group in the CIA, mind control, MKUltra, Hollywood. It's not one individual. It's a group of people, and they're doing something unlawful and harmful. Pizzagate, unlawful and harmful. Group, secret plans, conspiracies. They truly happen. Mainstream media is as a propagation, the propaganda arm of the CIA. Look up MKUltra. No, excuse me. Look that up too. But Project Mockingbird is where the CIA is absolutely determined to use the media for their own ends, to change public opinion and beliefs and everything, to hide, to keep their own stuff secret. And so what they've done using the mainstream media is gotten a lot of the population to trigger. Just instantly, they hear the word conspiracy, they think conspiracy theory, and they think conspiracy theory, and they think nut job. And they instantly dismiss it. And that's a total plan, that's why they do it, that's how they do it, that's why the deep state does what they do regarding conspiracies and conspiracy theories. It's an attempt to stop people from looking and thinking about what's really going on planet Earth. Okay? So, just wanted to say that about that. All right. Thank you very much for watching. And that's what I had to share today. If you have some theories on what's going on, who's doing what to who, why, share your theories down here too. It's not against the law to share your theory on what's going on in the world. And if you think it's a group of people doing something unlawful or harmful, and you know their plan, you know about their plan, any of the details, share it here. You'll be sharing your conspiracy theory. Okay? All right. Thank you for watching. Your thoughts are welcome. Your shots are welcome. No, I do appreciate the input, and I do block negative shit. I delete it. I block the people that drop it. So I'm not always on top of it every second, but if I see some negative stuff coming down, I mean, you can have a theory that is different from mine, and if you're respectful about it, and you're not calling people names, you're not getting gross or being crude and start calling people a lot of names. Fine. Says Rich, who calls people motherfuckers. You know, motherfucker. Anyway. Moving right along. Thank you for watching. And I will talk to you later, okay? Bye-bye.